In today's video, I'll be talking about the permanent maxillary second molars. The permanent maxillary second molar is the seventh tooth from the midline in the maxillary arch. This is the maxillary right second molar and this is the maxillary left second molar. According to the universal numbering system, this is tooth number 2 and this is tooth number 15. The buccal aspect is similar to the maxillary first molar except that the crown is narrower occlusal cervically and mesiodistally. The buccal groove is towards the distal side, as a result of which the mesiobuccal cusp is larger than the distobuccal cusp. As the distobuccal cusp is shorter, portions of the distal marginal ridge and the distolingual cusp are visible from this aspect. The lingual aspect is also similar to the maxillary first molar except that the distolingual cusp is smaller, as a result of which the distobuccal cusp is visible from this aspect. In some cases, the distolingual cusp is entirely missing. There is no cusp of Caraboli and the distolingual groove does not extend so far mesially and cervically. As a result, it terminates at a point which is occlusal and distal to the center of the lingual surface. In some cases, the groove does not even extend onto the lingual surface. The mesial aspect is also similar to the maxillary first molar except that it is shorter occlusal cervically. The contact area is larger and somewhat ovoid in shape. On the distal aspect, as the distobuccal and distolingual cusps are shorter and smaller, more of the mesiobuccal and mesiolingual cusps is visible. Other than that, the buccal aspect is similar to the maxillary first molar. The occlusal aspect is similar to the maxillary first molar except that it is narrower mesiodistally. There are two major crown forms. This is the rhomboidal one. It looks like the maxillary first molar and it is also more commonly found. The second type is the heart-shaped form. This is similar to a typical third molar. It has a very small distolingual cusp and a short distolingual groove. Sometimes the distolingual cusp is completely absent. With the exceptions previously mentioned, the cusps, grooves and pits are similar to the maxillary first molar. However, more secondary grooves are found on the occlusal table of this tooth. The root numbers and contours are similar to the maxillary first molar. The root length may be equal to or greater than the maxillary first molar. The two buccal root branches are equal in length and are closer together. They are also more distally inclined and there is a greater chance of their fusion. Coming to the variations and anomalies, the crown varies in shape. It is either rhomboidal or heart shaped. Sometimes there is a tubercle found on the buccal surface. The buccal roots are sometimes fused. Deflections and root curvatures are sometimes severe.